Alright guys, welcome back. A couple of guys who watched the FG Knot video last week, they came up to me on Instagram and they asked personally if I could share the type of knot that I apply on my snap or on the terminal deck. There are a lot of knots that you can use. However, the knot that I go to every time is the double loop knot. Why? Because number one, it's really, really easy to do. Number two, it's super strong. See, the main problem with having a knot on your fluorocarbon monofilament or shock leader, to say, right? The biggest problem is not applying the right knot. And then this knot, then what it does is it pinches that leader and hence you lose that strength and this eventually will snap out. So what I'm trying to explain is, let's say you do have a 30-pound leader. Now you put in a knot and what's going to happen is because of the characteristic of the line itself, you're definitely going to lose 20 to 30% of the strength. So 30-pound line, 20 to 30%, you're going to lose probably 10 pounds. So that line is now with the knot is going to be effective for 20 pounds. So with the double loop knot, you're going to minimize that. You're still going to lose a little bit of strength, but not as much as 20 to 30%. So I'm going to show you guys how I do the double loop knot. I hope it's something that you guys, if you guys find it practical for you guys can go ahead and try it out. It's a very easy knot, very effective. Yeah, let's go on with the knot. Alright guys, let's get to the knot. Obviously what we will need is, we will need a leader line, and terminal tackle. So here I've got the snap and I've got my swivel split ring combo. That's the reason why I use a swivel and split ring combo as opposed to using a snap. However, I will not explain this right now. I will explain in the upcoming videos. Now we're just going to get into the double loop knot. So to start the double loop knot, what I'll do is, from the end, I'll take about roughly 3 inches, pinch it with my thumb and my middle finger, and now switch hands, I will make a knot, a simple knot, like this, right? I'll make a simple knot like this, and then I'll pull it just a little bit tight so that it gets some memory on it, right? But I'm not pulling it that tight, just a little bit so that it gets some memory, and it remains like this, it remains open. Now what I'm going to do is, I'm going to thread this leader into the eye of the swivel and then send the leader back into the knot, like this. I'm going to thread it back in into the knot, like this. Alright, then I'm going to pull it. I'm just going to leave a little bit of gap at the back, probably a quarter of an inch. And then I'm going to tight this knot by pulling on the leader. So there you go, it's tightened up, right? Now to finish it off, I'm going to thread this into a simple knot. I'm going to go up on the leader, down on the leader again, up on itself, and down and up. A simple loop knot. Yep. So this is what it's supposed to look at the back. Then I'm going to tighten it up. It's my teeth. Right? So once you're done here, this knot is ready. The beauty about this knot is that it's not going to pinch the leader. Why? Because you basically have a knot here which is right now stopped from slipping by another knot at the front, another simple knot at the front. So basically what you're having is a clash of two knots, and these two knots are going to hold on to each other. You're going to hold on to each other and not causing a pinch point to the leader. That is why the double loop knot is the best knot to use on a terminal tackle. There we go. So once I've pulled it tight, all you got to do is cut it off. If you guys want to burn it, burn it. If you guys don't want to burn it, it's totally fine. Okay.